another very rainy day, and we're tracking thunderstorms moving into Columbia County right near Clarks Hill Lake right now, where there's some very gusty winds and a lot of lightning. I'll have all the details coming up.
Right now on News Channel 6 and 6, Augusta leaders working on a plan to honor a late department director, how that process will work.
Plus, with increasing property values in Columbia County, something else may be going up. What it could mean for your tax bills.
And in Aiken, a hotel getting a long-awaited makeover. Details as your news at 6 starts now.
Live from Television Park, this is WJBF News Channel 6 at 6.
Good evening, everybody. I'm Brad Meany.
And I'm Jenny Montgomery. Thank you so much for joining us. Coverage you can count on begins with Augusta Commissioners again.
A Columbia County deputy injured in the line of duty yesterday is home and recovering. The wife of Deputy Christopher Robertson tells News Channel 6 he's out of a hospital and he is doing well. And she says he is especially thankful for the first responders who cared for him.
Deputy Robertson was injured alongside Deputy Marshal David Willis yesterday while responding to a call at the Circle K that sits at the intersection of Furious Ferry and Evans to Locks Roads. Investigators say Tomisha Brown struck the two with her car yesterday while they were questioning her. She's being charged with aggravated assault and obstruction. Deputy Marshal Willis was released from the hospital yesterday.
It is Vacation Bible School with a twist. A local church's VBS is taking place in the backyards of church members' homes. Warren Baptist Church started its Backyard Kids Club, a.k.a. the BKC, during the pandemic back in 2020. And every summer since, they've had homes host VBS programs across the CSRA. This year, there are 25 host homes. Parents say at first it was a challenge, sure, but it has been a joy to see this experience grow beyond the church walls.
I love seeing our neighborhood come out like this. I mean, we're out in God's creation. We're enjoying fellowship and worship and all the things. But above and beyond just the kids who come to BKC, I think our neighborhood as a whole is on board with this.
BKC continues through the week of July 10th. If you want more information about how to get involved, you can find it on our website, WJBF.com. It is time now for a check of the weather.
And for that, we turn to Jenna Petracci. And Jenna, you're keeping track of a lot of rain this evening.
Yeah, it's been very busy over the last few days. We just heard some thunder and very heavy rain come down here at the station. But the good news is that this rain is moving very quickly off towards the north. So right now, we don't have any flooding concerns across Augusta. Here's the latest 1 hour loop, though, on Live Viper 6. It's that area with all the white dots there. That's all the lightning that we're seeing that just moved through town. That's where there's also the very torrential rainfall with gusty winds. So here's a closer look at that from Wilkes County, Washington, all the way across the border of Columbia and Lincoln County. That's where this leading edge is, and it's moving into Clarks Hill Lake. So if you are in the northern portion of the lake, go ahead and get inside. It may be tempting to be outside because you can see a cool shelf cloud coming through likely, but there is a lot of lightning here, so you definitely want to get into a safe shelter. And this will move quickly, though, and as you can see in Augusta, we're already starting to dry out. Just some light showers along I-20 into North Augusta and further off towards the northeast. Saluda County still under an aerial flood advisory, but as you can see, other than one light shower, all the rain has moved out, which is great news because they already got 4 inches earlier today. Now, the majority of the CSRA is under an aerial flood watch that goes all the way until Friday evening. We also still have a flood warning for Saluda County in addition to that aerial flood advisory, and that's for the Saluda River. Now, here in town in North Augusta on our Terry Lambert Hyundai Skyview cam, the rain has stopped, but it definitely is still very cloudy outside. With temperatures cooler from the rain, we're sitting in those low 70s. 74 over in Aiken Regional, 72 at Daniel Field, dew points in the upper 60s. Visibility pretty poor as well, only 5 miles at Busch Field because of all the rain and storms. Low pressure system down in our areas, which generating the thunderstorms, and this will stay in our area over the next couple of days. Still keeping those rain chances high Thursday and Friday. So we have a pretty high chance of flooding over the next couple of days. Widespread 1 to 2 inches of rain tomorrow again, in isolated locations reaching 3 to 5 inches. I'll have all the details on your forecast, plus a look at the future cast coming up, but back to you.
All right, Jenna, thank you. property values in Columbia County going up could also mean property taxes will go up. It's having an impact on the school board's process of selecting a budget for the next year. Hannah Letier has more.
Although the school board's millage rate could stay the same, property taxes could increase by as much as 12.2%.
This increase in property value could be due to the county's growing population and increased demand for housing. For the past 2 years, the board has lowered the millage rate. The question this year is whether to maintain the current rate or lower it again. There needs to be enough money in its fiscal year budget to cover resources for all of the new students in the school system. If the tentative rate gets approved, Columbia County parents hope their tax dollars are going towards improvements within the schools.
I mean, the cost of living here is substantially lower than most areas around the country. I'm in the military. I just came from Washington State, where it's actually pretty high out there, taxes. So, I mean, for me, if it guarantees a better future for my daughter, I don't have a problem with it.
There will be 3 public hearings on dates still to be announced for people to comment on whether the Board of Education's millage rate should stay the same or be lowered. After those meetings, a final decision will be made. In Augusta, Hannah Letier, WJBF News Channel 6.
The city of Aiken is tackling renovations for Hotel Aiken to donate blood.
Yeah, nice turnout. And a programming note for you for tomorrow. News Channel 6 is going to air a very special program at 7:30 tomorrow night. Barclay Bishop and Renetta DuBose hosting Finding Hope, Fertility Freedom. It's going to feature a panel of experts on ways to navigate the sometimes challenging journey to parenthood.
Jenna has another check of the forecast for us.
Well, we've had high rain chances all week long, and that's the case for our Thursday and Friday as well. Then over the weekend, rain chances slowly go down as our temperatures go up. I'll have all the details right after this break.
Now, your most accurate forecast with WJBF Live Viper 6.
Good Wednesday evening. I hope you're staying dry. We've had another day of a lot of rain and thunderstorms, and that's what we're watching now on Live Viper 6. This is all pushing off towards the north. Augusta just had a lot of rain come down, but it's moving quickly, so that's not causing any flood concerns here in town. Here's a closer look at that line that's really impacting Clarks Hill Lake area right now with torrential rainfall and a lot of lightning as well. So if you are in the northern portion of the lake where there's just some light rain, go ahead and get into a sturdy shelter. These winds are gusting up to around 35 miles per hour. And as I mentioned, a lot of lightning, counter up to 26 strikes over the last 26 minutes. Now, this line extends all the way from Wilkes County into the far eastern portion of Aiken County. So this is the line that's producing those gusty winds, but it is a very small line, so it's moving quickly. Just to the north of Aiken now, Wagner, Perry getting some of that heavy rain and gusty winds. Now, in Saluda County, no more rain, but we do still have that aerial flood advisory until 6:45 p.m. That's because they received 4 inches of rain in just one small isolated location with a widespread amount of 2 inches of rain all across Saluda County. In addition to that, there's a flood warning for Saluda River until further notice. And then this green shade here is an aerial flood watch that goes all the way until Friday evening. So today, unfortunately, is not the last day of the rain. Tomorrow will be very similar to what we're seeing today and part of Friday as well. Some wet roadways on our Terry Lambert Hyundai Skyview cam over at Washington Road. I've been seeing a lot of lightning as well out in the distance. So definitely be careful and try to stay inside at least for the next couple of hours if you can. 71 degrees as our temperature, so at least it's not very hot today. Still pretty humid though with a dew point of 69. The rain certainly cooled us down. We're seeing all low 70s and even 68 degrees up in Saluda with cloudy skies for everyone. The low pressure is now down along the border of Georgia and Alabama, and you can see this has been stirring up all the moisture and producing showers and storms across the southeast all week long. It'll eventually move up towards the northeast, and that'll give us lower rain chances over the weekend. So we just have a couple days left, but still going to see that chance of flooding over the next couple of days. Now tomorrow morning, cloudy start, few showers around, thunderstorms by the afternoon. We'll only make it into the low 80s once again, another well below average day. Here's our future cast tonight at 7 p.m. I definitely agree with this first portion of rain here from Wilkes County over into McCormick. Our model is suggesting more storms will pop up south of Augusta I do think we'll see a little bit more rain forming, but this is likely overdone. This will continue, though, till the overnight hours. We'll still see some scattered showers and storms here and there, so we will still have the chance of some more aerial flood advisories popping up. By Thursday morning, though, mostly cloudy other than some light rainfall. Then by the afternoon, storms pop up south of Augusta. This will be more scattered than widespread. And then by 8 p.m. on Thursday, some heavy rain, not as less storm activity as we go into our Friday morning, just some light rainfall, all really staying south of Augusta Thursday into Friday. So our northern counties, despite the rain they're seeing now, they'll start to dry out over the next couple of days, but still widespread 1 to 2 inches tonight into tomorrow, isolated locations such as Saluda reaching 3 to 5 inches of rain, and also a marginal risk of severe weather tomorrow, anywhere from Evans down towards the south. That's because any of those storms we saw in their future cast have the chance of producing some gusty winds. Our lows tonight will be in the mid to upper 60s, and for tomorrow, another cooler day, upper 70s for most of us, and right around that 80-degree mark. 85 on Friday, well, clearing Friday night. Good amount of sunshine over the weekend, only a 30% chance of rain on Saturday. Next week, we'll still see rain chances, but they're much lower, and temperatures will be consistent right around 90 degrees. Now, congratulations to today's umbrella winner. That's John Franklin from Martinez. John, you can pick up your umbrella here at the station, and you can sign up to win on WJBF.com.
All right. Thanks a lot, Jenna. Millions of insects called Mormon crickets are swarming across the western U.S. Look at that. The swarm started in Idaho a few weeks ago. It's already spread to Nevada. Homeowners have been using vacuums and power washers to try to clear them out. The Nevada Department of Transportation is now using plows to get them off the roads. Plows.
It's almost like an oil slick. I actually, at this intersection, was coming home, and as I came around the corner, I came around a little too fast, and I about ended up in the ditch full of water. It was pretty intense.
Well, it sure is. Experts say the crickets could plague that region for years to come until predators get rid of them.
Wow.
A lot.
How they stay out west. Coming up, we visit with the next generation of basketball stars at Dip Metris' kids camp.
Looks like a lot of fun there, as always. Brendan covers it in sports.
We're busy.
Casino injury attorneys. Now, WJBF sports coverage you can count on.
Our summer camp series rolls on over at Augusta University. Jaguar men's basketball coach Dip Metris hosting his 22nd kids camp. Mark here at Goldstein stopped by to check in on all the fun and fundamentals.
Augusta Jaguars head coach Dip Metris is hosting a basketball camp this week as a way to get kids more excited about sports.
Put the fun in fundamentals. Have fun playing basketball. Pure camp, no swimming, no movies. They're pretty active. The parents get in, they're tired by the end of the day, and we have a great time with them.
Many kids told me they are learning a lot about the game of basketball.
Definitely more about defense and dribbling and finishing.
But like Coach said, you still have to put the fun in fundamentals.
I love how there's so much stuff going on, and there's so much fun stuff to do.
Coach told me he wanted this camp to be available to kids of all ages.
6 to 16, 17, we got a couple 5-year-olds. We split them in 3 different groups, so they're with their age and ability, and a lot of different contests. Right now we're in 5-on-5. We play a little 3-on-3. Hot shot, hit or miss, knockout.
With such a big turnout, it looks like kids are really loving this camp.
Yeah, it's been a full week, about 100 kids, back to our pre-pandemic numbers, and we've had a great week, a lot of enthusiasm, and it's always exciting to have camp week.
At Chris and Barry Fieldhouse, Kira Goldstein, WJBF. News Channel 6.
Always a good time. Well, former Augusta Green Jacket Spencer Strider, another career milestone. Last night in a 4-2 win series opener over the Phillies, he went 6 innings, 1 earned run, 9 strikeouts, which makes him now just the second pitcher since 1901 to throw 300 strikeouts in his first 35 career starts.
Pretty impressive.
That is.
Dwight Gooden, the only other one.
Interesting. All right. Thank you, Brendan.
Stay with us, everybody. It's International Yoga Day. People around the world celebrating in their own way.
When we come back, see how India is celebrating today.
Safe homes of a...
From aircraft carriers, trains, and even in the mountains, People in India are celebrating International Yoga Day. All around the country, enthusiasts and leaders alike are practicing yoga in unique ways.
The United Nations declared back in 2014 that June 21st would be Yoga Day. It was proposed by the Prime Minister of India. He wanted to show all the benefits the ancient practice brings to anyone who chooses, or any animal who chooses to.
Yeah. Right, I was worried you were going to do yoga for this segment on air.
I'll do some goat yoga.
Isn't that just, I've done that before.
Yeah, where the goats walk on
you? Yeah, the only yoga I've ever done.
I'll try it.
This fun kind.
They're so dear.
Well, we have a lot more rain headed our way tomorrow. The potential of flooding and severe weather for our Thursday. Then we'll see some clearing by Friday night into the weekend and warming up back to 90 degrees on Sunday.
All right, thanks, Jenna. Thank you all for watching. We're back at 7 after World News Tonight.
And then we'll see you again for News Channel 6. That'll...